Okay.
You gotta pass a little exam to get the job, you know what I mean? And they tell you if you get it or not.
Et qui d'autre va parler? Moi seulement?
Si tu peux poser des questions, moi je suis prêt à répondre aussi, on parle tous.
Oui,
on est là dans la rue. Avec des règles, French anyway.
On va couvrir parler. Le flow et après tout le monde va parler.
Parce que les discussions,
moi je ne travaille pas là.
Oui. Pas de soucis.
Yeah. Well, good morning, Ghetto News on the spot. Well, thanks for the first thing is thanks a lot for coming along because we need for the media to know exactly what's going on in the territory. And thanks to people like Ghetto News coming along and seeing what's going on that everybody could hear and see what's going on. So yes, this morning I'm at Grand Maison. Grand Maison has been striking since Saturday. A number of workers has been striking because of the working condition. They are asking for a number of things that they are not seeing coming, but they are seeing it happening for other workers and not for them. So it is a discrimination. This is my first attempt to meet with them. I am in full solidarity with them, and all the time, because once it comes to the workers, this is what our mission is all about, defending the workers' rights. So they're looking at the 13e mois. Because MY is the 13th month of the year where they get a little extra pay in the year. Augmentation de salaire, which is a little raise on the salary. Ancienneté, their pass have to be taken into consideration also. Ticket restaurant, which is normally all enterprise of this caliber have ticket restaurant and they can use of it. It is not a gift ticket restaurant. It is a partnership between the workers and the authority. So they are also talking about an account. I guess that is when they need a little money that the boss or this job could give them a little extra or give them a little advance on the salary, on their own salary that they're going to take back off on the end of the month. So it is not a gift neither. Prime de Noël. You know that in Noel time is there where you have the big rush, where you have to do a little bit more than you used to through the year, because there's where everybody come in, everybody want a gift, everybody want a gift wrap and all of that. You want to be smiling all the time, even though you're doing more hours. So yes, it is a hectic time when it comes to Christmas period. Condition de travail, so hey, that is a little bit all over in every situation, all enterprise. Working condition have to be met to have a good working staff. So yes, they're asking to for the material adéquat pour le travail dans le bon dans de bonnes conditions. So they're asking for working condition. I can watch at everybody's shoe, for example. Everybody's supposed to have the. Okay, well, they will give you the detail of those things. Yeah. Yeah. So working condition in general is need to be put in to be met. Pause à partir de 14 heures. So 14 hours work.
Bonne journée.
You go eat at 2 heures.
For example,
okay, d'accord.
At 7:45 or 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock.
So you have to determine the pass. Okay, but
they eat at 12 and some of the cases they go eat at 2.
So you see there is a pause to the pause need to be organized properly that everybody know exactly how much is the pause and when is the pause so they can take it and be having a time of rest, a real pause, not a pause inside there when you still have to go up and down and eat later and that kind of thing, or don't eat at all, you know. So yes, those things have to be organized. Okay. L'employé qui fait travailler deux employeurs pour le salaire, pour un salaire. So, we have one employee who's making work two for one. So, they have two employees. Yeah, give me like an example.
And help somebody.
For example, I give an example. I is the person in the depot for Grand Maison. I prepare orders for home and tools, for example. I prepare orders for scent baths. I'm doing the work of two, three people on a one salary, you know, and still expect me to go on with my regular duties as going in the shop. For example, I'm not a salesperson. Most of the time, I'm on the floor making sales as well. My colleague, she might be a cashier. She got to leave what she's doing and go pack a shelf or so on and so forth. So it's overwhelming to still be held responsible for your responsibilities and still doing somebody else's work while you're not getting the motivation that you need.
Yeah, so to understand more or less that everybody has a mission, but some of them have to be extrapolating and doing more than what the mission is and still having to achieve what they're supposed to achieve for the day. So it is double pressure on one colleague while they could hire somebody else. So one person is doing 2% job.
But that's the key. They put that to
use and the polyvalent. Because if we feed you for 2 days, 3 days, whatever, we're gonna help out, you know what I mean?
When you don't have your polyvalent, if you are polyvalent, you cannot also have a specific task, a specific mission to go carry out. If you are polyvalent, polyvalent is polyvalent, and a task is a task, you know, a mission is a mission. So, yes, that needs to be clear for it also. Formation, you know, work, job training. Job training for...
They expect us to do a lot of things and know a lot of things that they haven't trained us for. Some of the knowledge that we acquired was on our own research and on our own... you know, influence. For example, we have machines in there that you're supposed to be able to use, and you gotta use it daily, but you never take the time to form the use of the machine. Now, imagine something happened, because at the end of the day, even if, for example, say you might have two or three was licensed to use the machine, but they're not available, so you're forced to use the machine under conditions. So it's unfair to those who want to learn and who using the machine to not get an opportunity to be formed in the machine.
Okay.
The girls, as men's as girls.
All right. Yeah, so they need job training, like you understand. It is a need because, yes, they have machine that they use. They need to practice on how to use them, how to maintain them, keep them working. Because when they break down now, my colleague here will be called upon to find out why it's not working anymore.
Repair himself as well, too. The guy that can come and repair here and get paid 300 euros just for showing up. Me, off of my basic knowledge and my research, go on Google, see how that works. I do my thing and I ain't getting nothing.
Yeah.
You know? But it's just to keep the work going and keep the team motivated.
So, yes, you have in front of you a motivated staff that is not feeling right because they are doing the part of the bargain, but on the other end, they are not seeing any results, at least recognizing their work and giving them what they due to continue what they are doing. We, the clients, we are well satisfied when we come here. So, yes, they also need to be well taken care of so they can satisfy us to the maximum. And today is not the case. Gris salarial, bricolage dans la convention collective. So I guess la grille salariale de Monsieur Bricolage, la grille salariale de Monsieur Bricolage n'est pas celle d'ici, or que c'est dans le même Monsieur Bricolage et Grand Maison, si je comprends bien, c'est le même siège, c'est ça. Hein? Donc c'est le même siège, sauf que certains ont un nombre de bénéfices et d'autres non, notamment ben, ceux qui sont debout aussi aujourd'hui, et je suppose d'autres qui ont un peu la peur dans le ventre à venir ou à se mobiliser, parce qu'on sait des fois que les contrats sont un peu craignos, donc ils préfèrent ne pas se mêler dans cette grève-là, même si ils souffrent les mêmes conséquences. Ok. La visite médicale, alors ils ont mis ça en point 12, mais c'est une obligation, c'est une situation où vraiment il serait nécessaire et obligatoire d'avoir des visites médicales pour le staff. Ça c'est une obligation aussi. Nos journées de grève doivent pas être salarié, alors puisque
ils vont nous enlever les journées.
D'accord, alors si je comprends, alors oui, alors les journées de grève, ils peuvent pas les décharger parce que effectivement c'est un droit. Ils sont sur place, ils viennent travailler tous les matins, mais voilà, c'est le droit. Aujourd'hui, ils utilisent leur droit c'est-à-dire de faire grève et de demander satisfaction au patron, au patronat, à la direction. Donc aujourd'hui ils sont là, this morning they are here standing because they have all these grievances here. There are a number of 13 of them. Well, the last one they are saying as the rights to strike. The rights to strike is what they are doing here, standing in front of the work, respectfully, and they are on time, and they are doing their hours. And sometimes when we strike, we're doing more than our hours because we're here from morning till the store is closed. Okay? Yeah. So it is very important that you guys stand like that, because even those that is not here, that is working here but is cannot be here this morning, should be here. Okay? Because they are working. The fight is for everybody. And today may be a sacrifice because you are not working and they're asking you to come here and stand up here and waste your time, that you may think. But in the future, next month, for example, if everything work out good, you will be satisfied by the fact that you have been standing here and your colleagues give you satisfaction because of your standout. So we know in this world, unfortunately, if you don't fight for it, you don't get it. So I am in full solidarity with the colleagues here, and I hope that St. Martin to understand that without them, we will be having, well, not the good service we have here. And they have a job, they signed for a contract, and they would like for their contract to be respected, because I am sure that they are doing their part. Okay? Yeah. One of these ladies want to have a little say.
Yes, you all want to talk and let's go down.
Vous voulez dire un peu pourquoi, quelles raisons pour lesquelles vous êtes aujourd'hui debout là? Qu'est-ce qui vous pousse à vous solidariser avec les collègues? Bien que j'ai déjà un peu expliqué, mais un peu votre sentiment profond.
En règle générale, juste un salaire décent, un salaire on travaille, et quand on est salarié, on n'a pas à être endetté. Oui. Voilà, c'est juste, on travaille et tout travail mérite salaire, et on ne peut pas vivre avec le SMIC, c'est pas possible. Oui. Voilà, tout simplement.
Et ça fait combien de temps que vous êtes dans cette boîte?
Deux ans et demi.
Deux ans et demi de service et problème de salaire toujours. Donc, une petite augmentation sera toujours la bienvenue, j'espère, je suppose.
Oui, puis quand on fait bien son travail, qu'on a des compétences, eh ben, le SMIC, ça, c'est pas justifié.
Oui.
En plus, ils ont la chance d'avoir que du personnel qui est trilingue. Ça aussi, ça se paye. C'est pas anodin.
C'est clair.
On pourrait tous se contenter de parler une seule langue et pas pouvoir interagir avec la majorité de notre clientèle.
Oui.
Donc ça aussi, c'est une compétence qui doit se payer.
Et oui, et très bien point relevé, parce qu'effectivement, on n'a pas besoin de traducteur. Quand les clients arrivent, il suffit d'appeler un collègue et voilà, il parle anglais, il parle espagnol, il parle français. Voilà. On est très cosmopolite.
Alors, toi,
well,
tu t'appelles comment?
Kevin. My name is Kevin. I work in rayon sanitaire and I hear and change in the store. As the youngest member of the crew, I feel like it's not right. Like for me, as a young, so I thankful that the older is fighting for the youngest too, because we have the future, what's coming up. So I feel that's the right move and what we should do. We should have people walk over us and fight for rights, as a St. Martin, you know?
Yeah.
So I feel that we're doing the right thing, no?
Yeah.
So I thank you all for coming and supporting us, no?
Yeah, man. It's welcome. It's natural. Yes, my brother. What's your name?
Claude Chatron.
Okay.
I work in Grand Maison. I've been here for like 3 years. And I know basically the whole store. So I speak English, French, and Spanish currently. So I ain't got no problem.
Yeah.
Now, we're fighting for the rights that we need over here, because they're stepping on our toes. And it ain't right, you know what I mean? And then we're going to keep fighting until this shit is over. I mean, excuse my language, but
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
Until this thing is over, we're going to fight. You know what I mean? Because we got a lot coming.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And they got to give us that, how you say, that encouragement. You know what I mean? They ain't encouraging us enough.
Yeah.
Coming here in the morning, they're telling you can't take a 5-minute break. You can't relax yourself. The sun hot sometimes. He worked in the back. And that heat, he can't come sit down for 10 minutes and be like, yo, why you sitting down for 10 minutes? We got this to do. Like, bro, if you go, you outside in that heat, You don't know how that heat is when he be in that container. When the shipment come in wrong, fall down, we got to go in the back. And he ain't supposed to work back there by himself. Yeah. And he's supposed to have another person.
And you guys are also talking about kapaz on the point 8.
We talk about kapaz on by 2 o'clock. Who go eat at 2?
Oh, your pause is at 2. This is what
most of us pause is at 2. I mean, not most of us, but, you know.
So those that finish pause at 2, at what time they finish?
Most likely 6 o'clock. Somebody
okay.
like me.
Okay.
I come in at 10. I finish, I get my pause at 2, I go back, I get 1 hour break, and I go back at 3. Okay. And from 3, I'm there till 6. So by 3 hours, you got to take maybe a 5-minute break or a 10-minute break. Yeah. But that's according to you. If you don't do it, they ain't going to tell you.
Yeah. Okay.
You know what I mean? We're looking for better condition. That's all we're looking for. All
right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Yes, good morning, my brother. What's your name?
Flanders Ivan. Okay. I is the warehouse manager here for the last 4 years. I'm the guy in the back, making sure everything gets to the front, preparing all the orders. I'm here today with my colleagues, standing our rights. I'm very supportive of what's ours. I mean, this right here stands for respect of the law. This article right here says that you cannot refuse an advance. Once we worked 15 days on the month, we should be able to get a little advance to push, pay the ADF, pay the SOAR or whatnot. The only reason why we're asking for advances is because the salary is at its minimum. They're barely giving us anything. They're benefiting from our sweat. They're benefiting from our knowledge. Like he said, all of us here speak at least 4 languages. Yeah. We speak French, English, Spanish, Creole. The list goes on. You take us out of there, a lot of customers won't feel comfortable. Some customers only speak Spanish. You got my colleagues who attend to them, and so on and so forth. So you're just asking them to respect what we do. The law itself, the article itself says what it says. We didn't make this up, you know, and there's so much more points that we could have put on there, but we're just fighting for what we believe we're entitled to, and we are glad that people standing with us and y'all are here giving us a chance to express ourselves. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome, my brother. Bonjour, good morning. Guten Morgen, Kuntabai. Once again, comment estas?
Bien. Okay. Y tú?
Tranquilo.
I don't speak Spanish though.
Yeah,
hi, good morning. My name is Adeline. Okay. I'm one of the cashiers, Chitik.
Chitik, yes. French Quarter?
Yes.
All right.
I'm one of the cashiers here at Grand Maison. Basically, one of my issues is with the conditions of...
Working condition?
Yeah. The chairs that they have at the register there, infernal. They hurting your back. You're gonna stand up because your back hurting you, but the chair's too low. So you've been down every minute, so you're hurting your foot. Mm. You can't work in those conditions. Yeah. We complain many times about the lighting in that area because they have the window behind us sending a lot of light. Then you have a whole bunch of lights over us and we have the lights on the screen. We have constant headaches. I just suffer from migraines and I just have to be on pills and all kind of, it's too much sometimes. The salary ain't making it. Like my colleagues say, our salary not even making us reach the end of the month. And we asking for our account, they telling us no. You don't know what I need. You don't know what bills I have to pay, etc. How you could tell me no for money that you owe me?
Yeah.
I already work for that money. All I ask you is to give it to me in advance. It ain't like I begging you for something. I asking you for your money. I asking for my money. And you telling me no. Yeah. That's ridiculous. Then you also have the fact that I cashing, but they want to tell me when thing on a body going to really unpack the shelves. But I got somebody in the shelf already. I got somebody in that area. So I must stop. Why do I need to go do somebody else's job? But
and what your contract says?
My contract is vendeuse,
caissier.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay.
But I in cash.
Yeah.
Which I asked them, I asked my boss already why it doesn't only say caissier.
Yeah.
And that's where he told me, yeah, but you have to go in the area. I said, but I have people in the rayon. I can't be doing somebody else's job while doing my job. Because when I'm in the rayon, somebody had a case, I got to run, go back. Then I got to run, go back, go pack the shelf. That's too much of back and forth. I can't be doing that. And next thing, for over a year now, a year and months. I know that.
We're gonna hold up for the airline. I guess that's the boss who are coming in there now. Are your bosses coming in and on this plane? So we're gonna just hold it up a little bit because of the noise. Yeah. So yeah, we are at Grand Maison and Green Cars, Hope Estate. And we are standing out here with the workers of Hope Estate. Some of them work in the Rayon, other works on the Caisse. And they are being asked to do, all of them, to do polyvalence. And it is harassing for them to be doing polyvalence at all time. Polyvalence, yes, you can be doing it, but when there's a situation, when they're asking you to help out a situation, but if you're doing it permanently, yes, you have to go back normally around the table and see not what. Okay, so you're saying not for the pay that you're getting, that doesn't fit.
No, it doesn't fit at all. It doesn't motivate us at all to do it, exactly. Mm. It's too much on one person. You're begging them for a mic.
Yeah.
How much are my cars? Like, you want to make
all depends.
All depends.
So, what you want the mic for to announce?
When we need to call somebody. Yeah. We had a mic that we could have used to call it. It would resonate in the whole store.
Yeah.
Over a year now, the mic mashup. We've been asking them to buy a new one. Every minute is remind me. But up to now, I can't it. So every time we need to call somebody, we gotta get up, run over by the accurate. Yeah. We could have a whole line of people. We gotta get up, run over by the accurate, go and use that mic over so to call. We ask them at time if it ain't possible to move that one, put it over so because we using it the most. We buy the case. I cashing people. I gotta call people on the mic. I gotta answer the phone at the same time. It could have people by sometimes the supervisor they self standing up by the accurate. The phone ringing. I got people cashing, and they wouldn't answer the phone. That's ridiculous. Yeah. That's ridiculous. Who does that?
Yeah. But they are the authority. They should be number one on answering the call and making sure the clients is being satisfied.
Okay. Because when I answer the phone, half of the time I can't give the client an answer. You know the answer already. Mm-hmm. Why not just pick up the phone and receive them? They'll have to call somebody else to pass them the phone. But are you radio?
Yeah. So we wouldn't use a name, but tomorrow is slave day. Eh? Tomorrow is abolition of slave. Eh? Exactly. So in Guadeloupe today. And then tomorrow is for St. Martin. Good morning. How are you doing?
Good morning. Bonjour, bonjour. Déjà, je vous remercie à vous d'être présent ce matin avec nous. Je remercie aussi Ghetto News d'être là aussi avec nous. Donc moi, je suis Mamoun. Je suis responsable de caisse. Ben, je suis celle qui fait tout. Donc du coup, aujourd'hui, je pense que c'est très, très important pour que nous, les employés de Grand Maison, puissent se réunir ensemble et revendiquer tout ce que nous trouvons qui ne sont pas bien. La façon que Grand Maison, ils nous traitent. Donc on décide aujourd'hui, depuis samedi, d'être debout. Parce que le salaire ici à Grand Maison, c'est le plus bas. On est en 2024, on peut pas travailler pour le SMIC. Quand il y a les visites des directeurs, des patrons, on nous met la pression pour que le magasin soit correct, que le magasin soit représentable, alors que c'est eux qui gagnent tout l'argent, c'est eux qui ont le salaire qui est adapté à ce boulot, mais on nous met la pression pour faire tout ça. Donc aujourd'hui, nous décidons de ne pas nous laisser manipuler encore et encore à Grand Maison. On décide de demander nos droits, tout ce qui nous revient aujourd'hui.
Et vous, ça fait combien de temps que vous travaillez là?
Moi, je suis à Grand Maison depuis avant l'ouverture. Depuis que Grand Maison était en construction, je suis à Grand Maison.
Ah ouais, et vous êtes toujours au SMIC?
Oui, je suis toujours au SMIC.
Voilà un peu l'exemple du traitement. Bonjour.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Farah Diafraissi. Ça fait depuis au début, je suis ici.
Ah ouais.
Et là, le SMIC, ça reste pareil, même niveau. Merci, tout, ça reste pareil, ça avance pas. Il y a des moments quand je mets tout seul dans le magasin, il n'y a aucun employé, je le fais tout, je le fais pas là. Au moment qu'il n'y a pas de caissier, j'ai remplacé les caissiers aussi. Alors, c'est pas évident, on n'a pas d'encouragement, on n'a rien. Ouais.
Ok. Merci. Bonjour.
Bonjour, moi c'est Gléina Abraham, je suis à Grand Maison. Ça fait un petit moment que je suis là, mais en CDI depuis cette année. D'accord. Et bon, je passe en dernier, mais mes collègues, ils ont à peu près tout dit. Ce qu'on n'a pas dit, c'est que ce qu'on a oublié. Mais bon, on est là aujourd'hui pour un combat, pour nous et pour aussi les prochains qui viendront après. Parce que c'est tout le monde qui va profiter après. Oui. Donc il faut qu'on se mette debout dès aujourd'hui pour nous et pour les suivants qui seront là. Voilà.
D'accord. Elle a effectivement évoqué le fait d'être en solidarité. Et la solidarité, c'est la force. Donc déjà, merci pour ceux qui sont là, pour les autres qui sont pas là. Parce que s'ils sont là, debout là, ça va servir à tout le monde. Donc merci pour eux et l'encouragement. Alors, nous avons vu atterrir un avion tout à l'heure là. Il semblerait que ce sont les patrons qui arrivent. Est-ce qu'ils vous ont contacté? Est-ce qu'ils vous ont dit qu'ils arrivaient? Est-ce qu'il est prévu une réunion, une négociation ce matin?
Oui, oui. Samedi, avec le directeur, on a eu la direction de Guadeloupe. Oui. Et normalement, ils nous ont promis que ce matin, ils seront là vers 8h30, 8h35. Et à partir de là, on va discuter et trouver une entente.
Un terrain d'entente. Ouais, parce que là, je pense que la liste est assez conséquente et il y a des choses qui n'ont jamais été vues donc et respectées dans le passé. Donc, je vous souhaite déjà d'entrer bonne chance et en tant que secrétaire général d'une organisation syndicale, ne lâchez pas parce que c'est le combat qui, malheureusement, c'est le combat qui donne satisfaction. Vous avez été très patient et très courageuse et courageux de continuer de travailler. Effectivement, c'est pour le pain quotidien, mais si ce sont que des miettes, c'est difficile de pouvoir survivre avec des miettes pendant que d'autres vivent la belle vie. Tout en sachant aussi, vous m'avez aussi évoqué le fait que beaucoup d'autres employés de la même boîte ont les satisfactions que vous demandez ici.
Donc, à l'intérieur, le directeur, les chefs de secteur, ils ont tous le 13e mois. Alors que nous, c'est nous qui travaillons tous les jours, qui font tout ce qu'il y a à faire. On a toujours la pression derrière nous et nous, on n'a rien.
Donc, on a l'impression que le 13e mois dont ils jouissent, c'est de votre transpiration, de votre sueur.
Exactement. Ok, donc. Je ne comprends pas, on est de la même boîte, on est sur la même direction. Donc, je ne comprends pas pourquoi il y a certains qui l'ont et pas d'autres. Moi, j'arrive pas à comprendre. Et ça fait un moment qu'on n'arrête pas de voir la direction, qu'on n'arrête pas de monter. Avant d'arriver là, depuis samedi, on a fait pas mal de tentatives, on a discuté, on a eu pas mal de réunions avec la direction. Toujours rien, parce que la seule chose que lui, il peut nous dire, je fais remonter là-haut. Je fais remonter là-haut et là-haut donne jamais de réponse.
D'accord. Et aujourd'hui, vous êtes effectivement mobilisé. Est-ce que vous avez une organisation syndicale qui vous suit, qui vous conseille? Êtes-vous affilié à une organisation syndicale?
Oui, nous sommes affiliés à la CGTG. Il faut savoir que nous, je crois que c'était l'année dernière, on avait pensé à nous syndiquer et je ne sais pas si la direction, ils ont dû entendre ça, on nous a mis une élection CSE tout de suite. Donc quand on a eu l'élection CSE, on n'était pas syndiqué, on n'avait pas un syndicat élu avec nous. Donc c'est après l'élection CSE qu'on a pu avoir la CGTG. Qu'on a pu affilier avec la CGTG.
Donc vous avez été aux élections en tant que candidat libre alors, dans ces cas-là.
Exactement. Ouais. Parce que c'est fait du jour au lendemain.
Et là, dans ces cas-là, c'est aujourd'hui la CGTG qui vous conseille pour le reste. Mais il ne siège pas en CSE.
Non.
Donc c'est vous qui siégez.
Exactement.
Ok. Donc voilà un peu la situation des camarades ce matin. Ghetto News. What can I say? Thanks a lot, my brother, because if you're not there, St. Martin would not know that these people are here suffering and they are here every day serving the population with a smile, but we didn't know that they're going through all of these things. So today we know. Today we are asking the population to be in solidarity with them. Pass along, they have two coolers here. They may need ice. They may need a little water. This morning also, it is provided that normally the buses are coming, and there will be a delegation going to see the bus this morning in the hoping that they will get satisfaction. I was saying yes now that the satisfaction will come bit by bit, because the list is pretty long, and the points are pending for years for some of them. So yes, they have to stand up, and I am proud of them, and I love to give you a round of applause, because you have stand up for yourself, and that is what you will, that's where you will win. Okay.
Thank you for coming out.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Okay, so this is Unity 978 supporting the workers of Grand Maison, and hoping and talking in the rest of the unions. You may not see them here, but a lot of them are supportive of your movement, and continue the good work. Pressure for a better, for good satisfaction and a better working condition, for a better retirement, a better health. Working, when I say better health for retirement, okay? Because if you're forcing yourself today, retirement, you might not live so long after retirement because of your straining all the time. So, tomorrow is slavery day. We have over 175 years now that slavery has been abolished on paper. Hmm. On paper, okay? We are seeing what is going on in Nouvelle Caledonie. I also is in full solidarity with Nouvelle Caledonie. We are seeing that slave master is having a different way of coming around, but he's still there and he's still doing his work, and he's not stopping. He's not stopping, and we all always have to be vigilant all the time. Okay, we know how it's easy to have a black man distract, give him a party, give him a beer, give him a music, and he'll be distract while they are doing what they want to do. Okay, in Nouvelle Caledonie, it is worse than what we live in here, but that is not the reason why we should take whatever they're giving us here. Okay, so Ghetto News, thank you very much. Waking up early this morning again, you know. So thank you for coming along. Thank you for the solidarity. Thank you for the image and the exchange on broadcasting to the rest of St. Martin and the world. You know, Ghetto News Ben Far is far right now. Blessed love.